Hello everybody, today we're going to be opening up Titan's Challenges in order to find the Gemstone Horse, Ruby. This Divine Horse was offered a week ago, actually. Unfortunately, I was not able to do my normal live commentary as I'm recording. I just wasn't able to get the audio that day. So today I'm just doing a voiceover, which means I already know what happens, but I'll keep it spoiler free in case you guys want to watch until the end. It's a shame that I couldn't get the audio because I do find it more fun to talk through the process of opening them as I'm going about it. But like I said, I wasn't able to get the audio, which is why I'm doing a voiceover. So Ruby was my second most wanted gemstone horse after Jade. Technically speaking, Ruby would be my third favorite gemstone in terms of profitability behind Jade as my number one. Sapphire is my second. But those two, Jade and Sapphire, I already have those two, and Ruby I did not yet have. I have been saving up for Ruby ever since I got Jade. Jade would have been my first favorite. He was my priority. So if Ruby had come out before Jade, I definitely would have just skipped Ruby, but thankfully that didn't happen. And I did have some items left over and quite a bit of time between both Jade and Ruby that I had enough for Ruby. At least I was pretty sure. I started out with 6 Titans challenges in inventory. I got those from either the item exchanges or winning them from events. So I just made sure to stock up on those. I had 5 Themis scales and more than enough Nyx packs in stock to get 3 Titans challenges per Themis scale that way. So in all, I think I had a total of, what would that be, about 21 Titans challenges technically from inventory, and then the almost 12,000 passes that you see in stock. Now, you will notice a few times that a Titans challenge or an Amezwing staff does pop up on one of the levels of the Titans challenges. Why did I not claim those? Well, I completely forgot that Horse changed it to where you do now get fragments even when you stop and claim your gifts. When the Divine Dust or Divine Fragments first came out, the only time you would get those is if you proceeded to the next level and lost. You did not used to get fragments when you claimed your gifts. You do now. However, I completely forgot that, and for the first 4 times that I saw that I had won a Titans challenge or a staff when I opened a Titans challenge, I just skipped over it and kept going because I forgot that I could claim it and still get Divine Dust. So then a couple more times when I did see that I had won those, I went ahead and I claimed it because you're essentially getting that Titans challenge back that you just opened. It was free. And then of course there were even still a few times after that when I remembered that I still skipped over the Titans challenge. I'm not sure why. I think it was because a few of those times I had seen that I had won that Titans challenge on level 5 or 6. And I thought, man, if I'm already up this high in the levels, and if I just go 1 or 2 more levels, maybe I can get Ruby. And unfortunately that didn't happen. So I think from now on, I should probably just bite the bullet and claim any Titans challenge or staff that I win when I open them. That way I can just get that one back, because the few fragments I was getting from opening these Titans challenges were really small. As you can see, I was getting anywhere between 9 and it was either 18 or 19 fragments was the most that I got at any time. And whenever we have a luck item offer that I'm really serious about, okay, I want this divine badly enough that I am willing to keep opening items to fill the meter if I have to, what I will do is that I will go into the events forum on International, where there is a new divine dust topic, and there are players that will post, you know, how many divine dusts that you'll get on that particular weekend offer. So I knew ahead of time, before I actually opened up Titan's Challenges, that you would get anywhere between about 9 and 19 or 18 dust for Ruby. So I knew, or at least I was pretty sure, I was about 98% sure that I had enough passes and Titan's Challenges in stock to get Ruby by filling the meter if I had to, because I just had a feeling that my luck would be terrible and that I just wouldn't make it to level 7 within like 20 Titans challenges or something on my own. I felt like I had already used up most of my luck on getting Jade. Jade, just to recap, I did do a video on that from start to finish of me opening up Titan's Challenges to get him. I got him when the dust meter was around, I think, 617, and it took me 47 Titan's Challenges to get there. So I didn't have to max the meter for Jade. And that was a combination of Titan's Challenges from inventory, a staff, and it took me 8,200 passes. So the equivalent would have been about 9,400 passes for those 47 Titans challenges. Obviously, at this point, it's taken me quite a bit to get to Ruby. It looks like I've completely used up all of my Themis scales, and I finally had to start in on my pass stash. But like I said, I had spent a lot of time preparing for this. I was selling a lot of draft horses and donkeys, which unfortunately are just not selling for as much as they used to anymore. So trying to get passes in this day and age is really hard. Something else I was not really thrilled about was the gifts that I'm getting. I'm not sure if anybody noticed it. We did on pre-prod a while back because we weren't sure if it was a new feature, like a change, or if it was just coincidence. But the prizes that you see on level one are the guaranteed prizes that you get if you lose on a level. So at this particular point, I have a Pluto's Parchment, Aging Points, and Carrots on level one. If I had tried to move to the next level and lost instead of claiming my gifts like I did, I would have gotten that Pluto's Parchment, Aging Points, and Carrots. So it's what you get on level one is guaranteed to be what you get if you lose. Whereas in the past, it used to just be random items. It wasn't always going to be a nice black market item like Azusa's Lightning Bolt or an Aphrodite's Tears. There were plenty of Titan's Challenges in years past where I lost and then my compensation prizes were just some Aging Points and Carrots. But at least you had the opportunity, the luck, to possibly win a better black market item. And I think overall, just the items in the Titan's Challenge are just not as thrilling as they used to be. I used to see Nyx packs pop up more often, and during this Titan's Challenge session, I don't recall ever seeing a Nyx pack on any of the levels. Granted, I didn't get to the higher levels very often. I think I did get to, did I get to level 6? You guys will have to tell me. There was a point where, you know, after I got into my pass stash, I was getting a little bit discouraged with how much it was costing me. And at that point, I wasn't even paying attention to the items that I won. I was just trying to get through it. Luckily, with Ruby, I was about 98% certain that I had enough to max the meter if I needed to. So I didn't have that same worry with Jade that, oh shoot, I've gotten so far and I'm going to come up short. Yes, the fragments do carry over now. So if I only got to 595 fragments and I had no passes or anything left to get more Titan's Challenges, I would still have those 595 fragments left the next time Ruby comes around. However, it's usually about 2 years between divine offers. There are the newer divines, I think some of the Nordics, I think we've seen the Nordic divine tier maybe 3 times. One of the Maori divines, Ryua, we've seen that divine. We saw it during the Christmas event, I think, which I thought that was an odd event to put that in, like a winter event. And it's more of like, just seems like a summery type of divine. There are divines that we've seen quite a few times within the last year. The wilds, we see the wilds all the time, and I'm really not a huge fan of the wilds, just because unless you get them for 200 passes, 400 passes, you're not going to make a profit on them because you only get, what is it, 80? I keep getting confused with the pass conversion. It would have been the equivalent of 8 old passes, so I think the equivalent of 80 passes now. Is that 800? I don't remember. But you don't get a whole lot of passes from them in their lifetime. So for me, they're just, you know, the divines, the chimeras, they're just really not worth it to me. But Ruby is a divine that I really, really want. I think he was the very first gemstone horse that was released, actually. And I didn't get him at the time because I wasn't really that good at making passes back then as I am now. So I didn't have the pass funding. He might have been released in the lottery the first time. I know Sapphire was in the potions because that was how I got mine. It was like one of the very first potions events that we had. Emerald. That was another potions event that I got her from, and I really wish I had picked, I think Jade was offered in that potions event, but at the time I didn't have many divines, and it'd be a 2-for-1 because you can breed her to get topaz, but neither of those two offer perks to their owners. But yeah, I really wanted Ruby, and it was getting a little bit discouraging seeing how many passes this was taking. And this is not sped up, by the way, at this point. Like, I just got very impatient. I just kept zooming through it. And also, I wasn't doing my, you know, commentary because I didn't have my audio recording while I was doing this. So, you know, I wasn't stopping every 5 seconds to explain in detail the gifts that I'm getting and why I'm so frustrated with getting these gifts. Like, why is Equus so often offered on level 3 now? I'm not really sure. By the way, I do have another video upcoming where I'm opening up Titan's challenges on the test server. That's something that's been requested a couple of times. It's something that I enjoy doing because I do find it fun to open up Titan's challenges on the test server because it doesn't actually cost me anything because those passes are given to us for test. Nothing that you do on the live or on the test server affects the live server, so those passes aren't coming out of my inventory. I don't get to keep anything done on the test server. It's just all for testing purposes. So I will be opening up more Titan's challenges soon, but it won't be my own actual passes. So we're getting pretty close here. Met like 981 fragments. Like I said, I kept thinking, oh my gosh, I have to open more. And it seemed like the closer I got, the less fragments I got per Titan's Challenge. The last few fragment amounts that I got were less than 12. And then I finally got Ruby by filling the meter. So if you're curious, the total cost for Ruby ended up being about 76 Titan's challenges versus the 47 it took to get Jade. I'd have to look back at my notes, but my first Baleos that I got in March of 2018, that one took me 35 Titan's challenges. The 3 Baleos that I got just recently in February, I believe it was, in 2019, I only recorded me getting the first one because it was a last minute decision that I wanted to get greedy and try for more. But the first Baleos I got from that session, it took me only 11 Titan's challenges to get that first Baleos. I think I was saying Ruby, but I meant Baleos. I'm sorry. And then I tried about another 9 Titan's challenges and I got 2 more Baleos. So I do believe Ruby is the most expensive divine horse that I have in my farm. But I know my notes don't go back for some of my older divines like Sapphire, Emerald. I don't think those cost too many, maybe around like 25 old passes. So those don't cost too much. I just got really unlucky with Ruby this time. I don't know what happened. It's like horse knew that I had enough in stock. So I had enough to get in. So it's like, we're just going to charge her everything that she's gotten. Yeah, but I did end up getting Ruby, and I'm really excited for it because he does give you 50 passes every time he reaches his birthday in-game. And it is in-game. It's not, you know, because I got Ruby on, he was technically born, I think August 4th is when I opened it and recorded this. But I get passes for his birthday in-game, not every August 4th. Otherwise, I'd only get 50 passes once a year, in which case I would not have bothered with him. That would have been too expensive. But that was me opening up Titan's challenges for Ruby. I would really like some of the more upcoming Gemstone Divine horses. However, Horse did recently re-release the Egyptian Divine Horse, which tells me that they're going to be in the process of re-releasing the other Egyptian Divines. And I really want a second Sekhmet. I'm not usually into getting doubles of Divines. However, Sekhmet offers Themis's Scale, and the one that I have offers it to me every 2 months. I have a lot of Baleos now. I have like 4 Baleos, so that's 4 Nyx packs I'm getting every month. That's 4 Nyx packs to use in combination with Themis's Scales, and I can get 3 Golden Fleeces or 3 Titan's Challenges or 6 Horns of Plenty every time I use those. That will help me get more Divine. So it's just really profitable versus the other gemstones that I don't have. They have a very random drop rate. And I think in the long run, Sekhmet would be better. I can get Sekhmet now, and then it'll be much easier to get these other gemstones when they're re-released in the future, even if I have to wait a while. But I don't know. We'll see. I'll have a lot to think about. But in the meantime, thank you guys so much for joining me today. I hope you enjoyed this Titan's Challenge opening session, and I will talk to you soon. Bye.